Hello and welcome to this next in a series of videos in which we're covering the subject of trunking. We've got the great honour of having lecturer Jake with us, who's going to help us out with this subject. And in previous videos, we've looked at an overview of the subject, we've looked at the different accessories that you might come across in the world of trunking, and we've also looked how to cut and treat trunking in those initial stages. What are we going to be doing in this video, Jake?
Well, Joe, we're going to look at cutting lid and fitting end caps. We're going to look at the more traditional way that you'd probably do this at college and on site, but here we like to work smarter, not harder. So we're going to look at a more efficient way that we've come up with ourselves.
Absolutely. So stay tuned to the end of the video for that, because you're going to find that really helpful to you. So what we're going to do now is we're going to bring the camera in really nice and close, and we're going to discuss some of those all important methods that we need.
So we've got our piece of trunking that we cut, Joe, and we're going to look at the two options we're going to be working with when fitting end caps. So here we've got the end that we didn't cut, which has pre-drilled holes ready for the end caps to be fit. So we'll go ahead and show how this end caps fit on this end.
So that's just a matter of just sliding that in there. And of course it's a nice tight fit, because that's what you want with your electrical enclosure. Very good.
Nice and flush.
Very good. And that's quite an important point, that being flush, isn't it? Because what that means is that we can see there, because these are the pre-drilled holes from the manufacturer, this is clearly how the manufacturer wants that end cap to sit on the end of the trunking there.
Yeah.
So it's not sticking out too far, it's not gone in too much. That is basically spot on. Very good, so one screw, and the next screw's going in now. And simple as that. So where you've got a situation where you've got the manufacturer's holes already pre-drilled in there that they've sent out as part of their trunking, that couldn't be easier, could it?
Nice and quick.
Happy days. Okay, so
flip this around.
Right.
So we've got the end that we cut.
Yep.
Which obviously doesn't have any pre-drilled holes, so we'll show how to mark them up.
Excellent.
And drill them, fit that end cap that way.
Fantastic.
So we've got our second end cap that we're going to fit in the side of the trunking that we've cut. So we need to mark this out. All we need to do is hold it. I'm going to use a fine pencil for this, it'd be much easier. All we need to do is just hold it against the trunking, make sure it's completely flush. Mark through. You can see that pencil mark there. Do that on both sides.
Very good. So, of course, you've got to make sure you've got the end cap sort of centrally located on the trunking as well, so that you get that mark in the right place. Very good.
So we can drill those out now. So put my block of wood back in there. So we'll put this in the vise ready to drill.
Of course, you've noticed that Jake's wearing gloves. Goggles are essential as well, because obviously we're dealing with lots of little tiny bits of flying metal when we drill through there, and if any of that gets under your skin or into your eyes, then that's going to cause you some pretty serious pain and harm, so we'll try and avoid that.
We don't want that. So flip the trunk in now, so drill out the other hole.
Interesting to note as well, Jake, you weren't going full throttle with the drill there.
No,
you
weren't
running at a slower speed, which is often better when you're drilling through steel. So you can see that Jake's removed that from the vise now and moved that onto the bench here. But of course, it's worth noting, Jake, that not every electrician on site is fortunate enough to have a vise on site. So what might they end up using instead?
Yeah, so they'll probably just be using a workbench instead if you're not lucky enough to have a vise like us.
Absolutely. But all of the same principles apply. Yep. It's just that slightly different way of holding the piece in place. So we've got the holes drilled. We drilled that. These are M5 screws that we use in here.
That's right.
That come from the manufacturer. Again, it's always worth checking. Our Accor trunking here uses M5 screws, but it's always worth checking with the manufacturer what size screws they use. So did we drill that at exactly 5mm, Jake?
No, we drilled it with a 5.5 bit, just to give us that bit of extra space. It wasn't super tight putting the screw through.
Absolutely, yeah, and that means you actually get a more secure connection. So that's gone in there beautifully, and you can see on the end there that that plate is sitting there just exactly how we want it to be, which is really, really nice. Happy days. Just pop the other screw in, and that's this phase done. So that is the end cap fitted, nice and rapid, nice and easy, and you can see that that's sitting on the end there really nice and neatly. Good stuff. Right, let's move on to talk about the lid. Okay, Jake, so we've got a trunking lid already pre-cut to 700 millimetres long here, which is really nice. Of course, we're not going to show you how to cut the trunking lid in this video because we showed you how to cut trunking in a previous video. And of course, it's all exactly the same principles. However, I noticed that this piece of trunking lid we're working with has no holes in it at all, Jake. So what's the story there?
That's right, yeah. So this piece that we've cut doesn't have the pre-drilled holes with the turnbuckles in, like this piece.
Yep.
So we've done that so we can show where and how we'll fit these ourselves.
Very nice.
So place the lid on first. So the lid's on the trunking. So you might think placing these turnbuckles would probably divide this length by three, so we end up with them evenly spaced. But that way we've got them close to the centre. We want them closer to the edge, so they're more effective. So we'll take this length and we'll divide it by four instead.
Very nice. So effectively you're going to end up with sort of a quarter, half quarter layout of these, these turnbuckles here.
And that gives us a measurement of 175.
That's quick maths, as Big Shaq would say. Very good. So 700 divided by four is 175 mil. And of course we've got the lengths along there, right? How are we going to get the distance across there right now, Jake?
Just measure across the trunking and divide by two.
Very nice. And that'll give us our centre mark across the lid there. Very good. Happy days. So that looks great. So now we know exactly where we're going to be drilling that hole through there. Fantastic. So there we go. So we've got two holes marked, which is more than enough for this length of trunking. That's going to keep that lid on nice and secure. So we'll crack the drill out and we'll get this drilled.
So we've got our drill with an 8mm bit in here, which is the size we need for these turnbuckles. So we'll go ahead and drill that now.
And we've popped that back in the vise there, so it's nice and steady for drilling.
So we've got our lid drilled out, ready to put the turnbuckle in now. We've got our flathead screw that just sits in like that. This then just sits on and slides down, and then we just need to push that down just to lock that in place.
So that just holds it and stops it from slipping out again. Very nice. Okay, repeat the process for the other one and we're good to go.
So now they're both in, we can set the lid back, pop it back on the trunking, secure that in place.
Excellent, and that's our next piece of trunking lid complete. Good work. Okay then, Jake, so we've seen the standard way of fitting end caps and trunking lid, and you'll be able to do that for any manufacturer's trunking. And what we're going to do now is we're going to give full credit to a friend of the show. What are we going to look at next?
Yeah, so this wasn't fully our idea. So this is, we got this from Eddie at Pegasus. We've pinched his idea, which he did for another brand of trunking. He created a template to drill out the turnbuckles and the holes for the end caps. So created one here for ours.
So this is just a piece of trunking lid and we've pre-drilled a hole in the right position so that when you just pop it on the end of the trunking there and line it up with the edge, all you've got to do is either mark up or drill straight through that hole, and that's your position for your end cap there. Yep. That's brilliant.
So we needed an end cap on this end. Hold that flush with the end of the trunking and drill straight through.
Oh, that's brilliant. Yeah, that's really clever. Love that. And what's the other purpose of this? So there's some big holes in the middle there.
Yep, so that'll do the turnbuckles for our lid. So this will work for the 50 by 50 and the 100 by 50 as well. So for example, if we're doing the 50 by 50 trunking.
Yep, so we'll just have a look at that.
Hold that in place.
So again, you can see there that that turnbuckle in the middle is just nicely seated when you put our template on the edge there. That's fantastic. So again, if you're doing loads and loads of these, then actually that's going to save you loads of time because you don't need to keep measuring up with a tape measure. You can just pop the template on, mark the holes or drill the holes straight through there, and you're ready to go. So there we go. In this video, we've looked at how to install trunking lid and also those end caps in a really neat fashion, but also in a really accurate way, because obviously that's important for the final look, but also the continued operation of our trunking systems. Where are we going to go next in this series, Jake?
So next we'll take a look at fitting some pre-manufactured accessories, some flat, internal, external 90s, etc. And then we'll actually go on to manufacture some of those ourselves as well.
Oh, so we're going to do a bit of metal munching, aren't
we?
Excellent. We'll look forward to that. But as always, we want to hear from you. What are your thoughts? What are your questions on this subject? Have you maybe seen something we've done in this video and think you wouldn't do it that way? Have you got any top tips or top tools that you would use on your trunking installation? Whatever those thoughts are, whatever those questions are, please leave them in the comments section below, and Jake will be sure to get back to all of those for you. But as always, all that remains in this video is to say
thank you very much for watching.
I'm serious. Keep taking my line.